Welcome to the Daly City Recreation's meeting for January, not January, but February 28th. I was just handed the minutes from last month. may we have a call to order, please?
Commissioner Luna.
We're here.
Commissioner Braunier.
Here.
Commissioner Landers.
Present.
Vice Chair Cisson.
Present.
And Chair Pastor.
Present. May we all rise for the pledge of the flag, please.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Here.
No, this is the one today.
That's mine. Go ahead.
January.
My apologies for jumping the gun on the roll call, but again, may I have an approval of the January of the agenda this evening?
I'd like to make a motion to accept the agenda.
One second.
Okay, those in favor say aye.
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 Okay. And a motion for the approval of the minutes of January 27th. May I have a motion for that? I'd like to enter a motion to approve the January 27th meeting. And those in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Okay. So moved. Starting with the director's reports, we have the first item of the Daly City Baseball Association discussion.
Thank you, Chair Pastor. Sure. Before we go there, I want to acknowledge some of our visitors this evening. Great. Starting with our mayor, Glenn Sylvester.
Come here.
Our vice mayor, Jess Limonallo. Our recreation services manager, Denise Brown. And recreation supervisor-ish. Senior supervisor, Romeo Benson. And then we'll be hearing from our friends from the Daly City Baseball Association. This was an item that we talked about at our last meeting.
Right.
And just to catch everybody up where we were, the Daly City Youth Baseball Program has been around for a very, very long time. In fact, Chair Pastor probably has some history with that. What we have seen over the last 5 or so years is a significant drop-off in participation in our baseball program. The kids play t-ball, so the kindergarten-ish, first grade, second grade, and then the numbers plummet. And part of that is the players that are good and want to do competitive baseball are moving to other programs outside of Daly City. Specifically, they're going to Pacifica and South San Francisco. And so those programs are getting an influx of Daly City kids. And part of the reason is they want competitive baseball as they get older. And the recreation baseball that we offer just isn't enough for them. So we started discussions maybe a year ago, thereabouts, with Daly City Baseball Association, maybe longer even. They are an official 501c3 now in Daly City. They have a board, and the president and some of the board members are here this evening. And we've talked about a partnership with them so that we continue to offer the product that sells well for us, and that is t-ball and baseball for first grade and second grade. But we hand off the baton for the competitive baseball to the people that are really good at it, and that's the Daly City Baseball Association. So what we're looking at long-term is transitioning baseball out of recreation altogether into the hands of the Daly City Baseball Association, which we would support through registration and field reservations and all of the components that they need to succeed. The baby step in that relationship is this summer, they will be offering, for the first time in conjunction with us, a week-long baseball camp for children. We are handling the reservations and the field. They are going to run the program as a contractor. So those of you familiar with our summer programs, we offer a bunch of summer camps for kids that we do through contractors. We do volleyball, we do basketball, all sports. But this is the first time in quite a while, at least in my memory, that we're offering baseball. And we're doing it through the Daly City Baseball Association. So I wanted to take a minute to introduce the president. Angelo, maybe if you can come up.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Well, like Joseph mentioned, myself, Ronan, Maria, we established the Daly City Baseball Association 2 years ago. And we've been part of the Daly City Baseball program for many years. I've been coaching since T-ball, my son Javier, and my two other sons, who are now in college. So, and we've been part of this Daly City program for many years, coaching from T-ball all the way to sixth grade almost, and participating in all the programs. So we've seen what's been happening with the baseball program and how many of the talent has been going away to various different cities. What we've been able to do, though, in the last 2 years is establish our own unified, if you will, families. And we've established travel ball teams at a very high level of competition. So we take these travel teams and we go all throughout the Bay Area, play in Fremont, Tracy, Vacaville, and we have a strong following. And so what we've been able to do is sort of incorporate some of the talent that's been coming through the Daly City program and taking those kids and keeping them within our Daly City program so that, you know, we keep all the families involved and all the kids involved in our program. So we look forward to this new opportunity because we want the kids to have an opportunity to continue to play baseball in Daly City. We've seen other programs. In fact, my team, which was a 10U team, played in South San Francisco this past year. At a very high level, we made it all the way to the championship. And we've seen what other programs can do when it's run by folks who are really care for the program. And I think that's what we have to offer. And so this relationship with Daly City is something that we look forward to. And it's gonna be quite a challenge because obviously the signups have been dwindling throughout the years. But I think if there's a new face and there's a new story to tell, then things could look, you know, for the future to be better and to continue to have baseball within Daly City. So that's what we have to offer.
Would you like to introduce
Absolutely.
And bring up the rest
Thank you.
Of the team?
So Maria Villarreal, she's
spokesperson.
And our vice president is Ronan Gadario. That's my wife of 20 plus years, Carolyn Aww. Manila. And our kids.
Come on up, kids. Come on up. Come on. This is all for you.
Absolutely. We've also been able to generate a lot of businesses and in fundraising. For example, Dave and Buster's has recently come on board to be one of our main sponsors.
Good.
Lucky of Daly City
Good.
Has sponsored us for many the last couple of years now, right? We just got a great fundraiser from Disney. So we're getting our name out there. And mm-hmm. it's baby steps. This is our second year of really just going after it in regards to just getting exposure throughout the community. And we feel confident that once the name gets out there, that it's gonna be synonymous with the strength of the Daly City program. And that's our goal.
And I just want to add that there is interest in the age group that we're targeting. We have a website, and people every week are signing up. To date, I think we've had about 40 kids sign up.
Yeah, about 50 kids.
Yeah, so there's interest. There definitely is.
What is the website again?
DCBA Sports at DCBA.com.
That's our email.
Oh, sorry.
Forgive me.
Sports.com.
There you go. Can you do that again on the microphone so that the everyone in public can
it's
get that?
It's dcbasports.com.
Thank you so much.
Slowly, in case someone's interested.
Yeah.
dcbasports.com.
dcbasports.com.
So while we're at it, I had a couple questions, but since we have the mayor and the vice mayor, I'd love to get a photo op with you all. Why don't you all get up, too? Come.
Yes, this is the beginning.
Yes.
I totally agree.
Don't you agree?
Yes.
Watch out, Romeo. I'm going to get you up too. Romeo's like, no. Come on, please.
Yes.
Come. Yeah. Come. Here, let me grab a picture of you guys. Kind of reverse.
We'd like to include Joseph as well.
Joseph too, not your back.
Yes.
Come on, Joseph.
Yes.
Joseph's like, oh, God. Okay, guys. You got it? Please, one more. Okay. Ready, everybody? Go. Thank you
there
so
you
much.
Go.
Yeah. So I do have a few questions and just in curiosity's sake, now that you thank you, Mayor, thank you, Vice Mayor. Sorry to put you all on the spot. I just had a couple questions. So you've been around 2 years now. And so what grades are, because, you know, when I think of baseball, it's like kindergarten or first grade or second grade to eighth grade. So where are we at? I know you have to build. It doesn't happen overnight. So where are we at or where are you at with regards to grades or classes or
age?
Near the mic.
Oh, okay, sure.
Age groups.
We want to support the ages from 9 through 13,
okay.
Which incorporates third grade, fourth grade, fifth and sixth, and seventh and eighth grade. So that's our starting point. Park and Rec is still going to be taking care of the T-ball and farm league divisions.
So when I remember when my kids were in baseball, they went through school. They played in school, so through the grades, through the public schools. So how are you tied in with this public schools? Or are you? Or just the kids come out of the public or Catholic schools and come see you and join your group?
We've sent out flyers to the schools. We got it approved through the Unified School District. I've gone around to some of the middle schools and talking to the PE teachers or who's ever in charge of MUR after school program that we have this program going on. So we're trying to get schools to set up their own teams. This year, I think we have 4 schools that are in the process of setting up their own teams. So mostly all elementary. We're trying to get the middle schools, but I think it's just a work in progress on that part. But we're working on that.
And so I'm sorry to ask these questions, but I don't know if anyone else has the questions. So let's just say there's someone who'd like to join, mm-hmm. and like to play, and they've already gone through Daly City, mm-hmm. T-ball, and then they hit third grade. They want to play, and they are not doing it through their school. They would contact you, and is there a fee?
Yeah. They register online on our website. It sets up an account for them, and the fee this year is $125.
And that includes the uniform?
This year they includes the uniform and the hats. They get to keep that this year. And then it'll be about 12 to 15 games that we're going to be playing for this season. So,
very good.
We also offer scholarships to children that, you know, need a little help joining.
Nice.
Well, thank you. Yeah. Well, you know, that's a good point because it answers a question I had about for those families that have more than one child.
Or, not turn them away.
Or, yeah, and... So it's good to hear that you have some scholarships out there. And I just want to say thank you for carrying the ball and moving forward on this. I know that I've seen over the years and heard over the years that the decline of that age group has dwindled down to where your teams weren't just being formed, but there's coaches there to have a team.
Absolutely.
Or sometimes the vice versa. There's a team, but no coaches to teach the kids along the way. But I just want to give you guys a big hand for kind of like continuing on the program in Daly City. It's going to fill a big void in this town and another opportunity for the kids to participate in another sport other than what they see on TV. So, again, thank you.
We're Daly City residents. I graduated from Westmore High School.
Yeah.
Bronin's from Daly City. So
great.
We've been through the programs and, you know, I played baseball in Daly City, so it's true to heart.
There you go.
So, you know, what we teach other coaches through our coaches clinic is basically making sure that they teach the kids the right way, mm-hmm. because it all starts with the coaches. That's what we believe that since day one, to have a great program, it's all about the leadership. And so we're gonna you know, teach that to the incoming coaches, you know, throughout all the grades.
That's good. Okay. Thank you.
Director Joseph, we have a website, right? The Daily City website.
Yes.
Right? Is it possible to be able to link their website there?
It is currently.
That was my next question.
And what we're, I mean, just by way of background, this conversation's been going on for a very long time.
Okay.
And the progression is natural. If you look outside of Daly City, youth baseball is typically done by a nonprofit group,
correct.
Not so much the cities. Correct. Daly City's always a little bit different the way things work.
Right.
So it's a natural progression to turn it back over to a nonprofit group, but with our support. Like I said, we have the fields. They don't have any fields of
That's
their
right.
own.
That's right.
We've got a very sophisticated registration system.
That's right.
That, you know, we can work together. We're the first step in doing that is for the summer camp that they're offering
That's
this
right.
year.
That's
but
right.
we're looking That's forward right. to a day where it's a complete transfer of baseball to them, but still being a active partner, both in terms of getting the registration
Correct.
Online and also scheduling the fields, which can get pretty complicated. There's a greater demand for fields, whether it's soccer or baseball,
That's right.
than we have.
Yeah.
So San Francisco is experiencing the same thing. Another thing I want to add to, you talked about the schools. A lot of the Catholic schools in the area
Correct.
Play in the San Francisco Parish League, which is at the very bottom of the totem pole mm. in San Francisco in terms of getting fields. And so we've already been approached about welcoming some of the San Francisco schools and possibly the Daly City Catholic schools into this league, where they know they're going to have fields and they know they're going to have
That's
parking
right.
and
That's
they know
right.
it's a quality program.
That's right.
I don't want to badmouth San Francisco Public or Parish League Baseball, because it's not necessarily their fault. San Francisco is so impacted with other competitive leagues at the Parish League,
yes.
it's sort of fallen by the wayside. And these poor kids, you know, their schedule actually came out this week. These teams don't even have a place to practice. They got to jump right into their first games this weekend in mm-hmm. the Parish League. So they are very interested in next year. They're already committed this season to San Francisco, but they're very much interested in moving into Daly City. So the potential for growth is really, really big over the next year.
Right. Well, in fact, that's the in Europe and even Australia, the public infrastructure is basically managed by the city, but then they have the private entities to manage the programs, mm-hmm. and it becomes actually inexpensive or affordable than a private having to own their facilities, and they always go bankrupt, like the tennis academies now. So. But in fact, many government, like in Kentucky right now, as we speak, is opening up their public parks to programmers such as that will continue that program. So it's a private-public domain, basically.
And I was just going to just say that it's nice, because we've had this discussion over the years, and our biggest concern was losing our children to Pacifica, to South City, and they go scouting, so they go looking, and when they see someone's really good, they reel them in, and they, yeah. you know, they entice them to go out. So with your quality program, it's the hopes that, I know your hopes is that you keep these children and that they grow, and it also would benefit our high schools as well, because they stay in Daly City and
Correct,
they'll
yeah.
play hopefully
within
in,
the community
with
yes.
it, you know, at Jefferson, at Westmore, at Terra Nova, and so yeah, there's always a good so thank you.
So we'll
this conversation has been going on for so many years.
Yeah.
Remember, we had one at Duggan's with a lot of the players. I think before you got involved.
Yeah.
So.
Yes, yes.
This has been something that didn't happen overnight. It's yeah. been a long, thoughtful discussion, and it's starting to bear fruit. And hopefully in the years to come, it's going to be very successful.
And
we're looking forward to the relationship.
I'd like to keep the door open in terms of when there's successes out there or where there's progress you want to report, the door is open to come on in and let us know.
Sure.
Because by letting us know, you're letting the community know.
Well,
so.
this relationship is huge, because
yeah.
name recognition alone is going to validate our program.
Right.
You know, with word of mouth and our relationships throughout the, not just the Daly City community, but with the San Brunos and South Cities of the world, where we have teams that play in those programs. And so they know of who we are.
Yeah, yeah.
And that some of those kids are starting to come back into our program. So we you know, it's not going to happen over, you know, overnight. It's going to be a slow process, but it's there.
So when you win, when you're winning those championships, you need to come back and you come to the recreation meeting and be on TV, and we'll introduce you and take pictures, and we'll have the mayor and the vice mayor come.
Oh yeah.
What do you say?
Look at our website. There's trophies galore with
absolutely.
With our
then you come. You come back. Come back and see.
We would be happy to see some of those pictures here in the meeting. We would be happy to see what have you guys experienced. You know, from being together, and also from this day forward, you guys are welcome. So always come back. We'd like to hear, including the public as well.
Absolutely. Appreciate that. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. I just want to add that I happened to be at Dick's Sporting Goods about a day ago, and I walked in, and there was a sign that said, "Welcome San Francisco Youth Baseball." So perhaps, like, you know, this summer camp will sort of encourage other businesses to actually start helping as well, and kind of open their eyes to what's going on.
Dix has sponsored us for 2 years in a row, so those days are those special days where it's a special sell day for the, like, the San Francisco baseball youth.
Mm-hmm.
So it encourages them to go there because they get a 20% discount or 15% discount.
Got it. Nice. Yeah.
And actually, Dix is our website is through Dix.
Yeah.
Now.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Nice.
So
awesome.
Yeah, this year we converted our website because Dix offered us a brand new website. That would have cost us $5,000 if we wanted to do it ourselves. And they gave it to us completely free.
Wow, that's great.
And we just had to provide the content. So Dix is our special official sponsors.
Nice.
Besides other companies here.
Right.
Well, I look forward. I know we'll see you. I'm not going to say goodbye. We'll see you again soon.
Yes.
I'm sure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
May we give an applause?
Yeah.
Thank you, Angelo.
Thank you, Bill.
And thank you, Joseph, for making that happen. Yes.
Okay, the next item on the director's report will, or unless we have some more questions on the Daly City.
No, I'm good. I would like to make that real possible and, make a motion.
Okay, fantastic. And moving forward, got changes to the activity guide coming forward?
Thank you, Chair Pastor. Again, to give some of the newer commissioners historical perspective, in the olden days, we followed the seasons. So there was winter, spring, summer, and fall built around recreation. And our seasons were featured in the what was then a quarterly activity guide that was mailed to every postal customer in Daly City. As the budget ate away and ate away at our marketing budget, we streamlined it to, instead of covering four seasons, we combined spring and summer into one, and that's also the activity guide that featured all of our summer camp programs. What we are looking, which by the way, will be coming out any day now.
Friday.
On Friday, we'll have the new spring summer guide out. But what we're looking to do, I'm just giving you a heads up, for next year, rather than combining spring and summer, which are both really robust seasons for us, we would have a spring, summer, and fall, winter combined. Did I get that right?
No,
I got it wrong.
Winter, spring.
Winter and spring, summer. Winter and spring, and then fall and summer would be standalone. Sorry. And the other, we did talk about this again for the newer commissioners. We no longer mail that activity guide to every postal customer in Daly City. The cost of printing and postage together was extremely high. But that's the way of the past, too. The trend in our business is online registration. So, you know, 75% of our customers are return customers, and they're registering online. They're finding their courses in our online catalog. So we're going to continue to drive traffic to our website to do that. But at the same time, we do print fewer activity guides. We don't mail them anymore, but we have them at strategic places like libraries, City Hall, or admin offices and schools and such.
Duggins.
In fact, we'll share the new one with you at our next meeting. So people still like, there are people that still like to hold mm-hmm. the paper copies, but the good thing is more and more people are going straight to the source online. So the expense of postage and printing the hard copies is not as necessary as it was, you know, 5 years ago.
Right.
So that's a good thing. So we're saving, I want to say, in the neighborhood of about $40,000 a year. Which is a significant amount of money for our department.
Yeah.
And we're not seeing enrollment in our classes and camps decline because of it. People know where to go.
Right. Right. That's good to know.
Happy to tell you that our swim classes continue to be completely full. So with or without the activity guide, people know where to go to register.
Great, great. Well, thank you for that heads up, especially the news that we're saving money on that and still having folks find their way to the website and getting more comfortable using the website to register their youngsters.
And so at our next meeting, you'll have as a handout the spring-summer activity guide along with a standalone summer camps guide.
Okay.
That will be coming out this week.
Great, great. Well, before we move over to Commissioner's report, just want to ask any other questions relating to the activity guide we want to present to Joe? Okay. Well, we do have a couple guests with us I'd like to introduce. And first of all, we have our mayor, Mayor Glenn Sylvester. And also, we have our Vice Mayor, Jocelyn Manolo. And let's see here. Commissioner's report. Oh.
You want to speak?
Two cards.
Right. Mayor Sylvester.
Yes.
Did you have anything to share with us?
Honorable Chair Pastor, Vice Chair Cecil, Commissioner Peruano, Landos, and Luna. I am happy to be here this evening because I think back when I was walking the campaign trail and many folks came up to me and says, why doesn't Daly City have a baseball program? And I wondered, and I've heard a couple of comments, well, where do your kids play? South San Francisco. And I care about these kids so much that I actually donated money for South San Francisco for the kids to play. And I am so happy that the group came here today because what I got from the group is, number one, is the passion. Number two is, you ever see that commercial about the hair? I'm not only a user, but I'm a client or whatever. to have kids grow up in that environment, it shows that they are for real. There are many 501c3 organizations, and as Director Curran said, this organization stepped up. They actually stepped up to the plate, and that says something. And I have no doubt. And in addition, while I was walking the campaign, there was one union person who said to me, you know what, if you have any sports programs, let me know. I said, why? Well, I'll get you some uniforms. So I'm going to start looking through all my contacts and try to find that one person. I want to help this organization. I appreciate the fact that in Daly City, we try to work together, as Director Curran had said earlier, because finding a field to play on is very tough, and folks will come from all different cities to try to use our fields, but I would hope that if it's a Daly City organization, that they would someone get top priority over others. So, commissioners, I urge you to approve this organization, and I want them to know that you definitely have my support. I will be there for you as well. Thank you so much for allowing me the opportunity.
Well said. Thank you. Vice Mayor Jocelyn, thank you.
Good evening. Thank you, commissioners. I just wanted to say thank you for your work. And I feel the energy already of the commission and can see just the great ideas and dynamic from all of you and your heart and passion for the city of Daly City. I'm just enlightened to hear how this nonprofit came to be, and that a lot of the coaches and these folks have been residents and care about Daly City, are from Daly City. And that's so important to see, and that's what community is all about. And I'm just thankful that they've come out here and they see a need and they're willing to step up. And seeing that come from the non-profit sector, and also hear their collaboration with the private sector and now with the public sector is so important for our youth. And so if there's any way or anything that you need, I'm also here to help. And it's just really enlightening to see this. And if it's in helping promote more of your organization or in whatever way. So thank you for your dedication for the youth and your continued service. And I have the same feeling as Mayor Sylvester. It's you guys have 50 kids already. I think, you know, there's a lot of young people that will utilize the service. So thank you for this opportunity. I'm really excited to see all of the great work ahead. Thanks.
Before we move on to announcements, do we have any commissioners' reports that we'd like to bring to the table?
Before we go anywhere, did anyone want to speak about the handout? It's lovely, but I mean, I didn't know if someone wanted to point out what it was.
That is from MH Tobias School. It's the newsletter that they produce in the after-school youth recreation program. Thought we'd share that with you.
Very nice.
Very well put together.
Especially the artwork. I really,
it reminds me of Highlights Magazine.
All right, I'm just going to say this. So After School Youth Recreation Program is one of four locations in Daly City that serves youth in the elementary school age. Panorama, MH Tobias, Daniel Webster, and Juniper Serra. So those are the four locations. And if you are a youth and you're interested and you've heard your school name being called out, you can register. Here's the fee, nominal fee, and you get 5 days a week after school till about 6 p.m. MH Tobias is one of the sites that provides that newsletter. It comes out once a month. So there you go.
Well, then just through the chair, the commissioner's report, I would just like to say that I attended the Black History Month celebration, and you know, I wasn't there alone. I saw my fellow commissioners and the mayor and the vice mayor, Joseph. It was an amazing celebration. Not only, besides the food was really good. I took it to go. It was good food. But the music and the dancing and the poetry and that the emotion, it was a beautiful event. How did you feel about it? I saw you there.
I love the way they express their feelings, how we are connected with them, and what we're sharing thoughts we can do together, and plus how they express their care for us as well. So I stayed till the very end, and I met some people that I haven't seen so long time, and it was wonderful, and I look forward to seeing that again.
I had an opportunity to check out the first part of the event there, and I just want to congratulate Leslie Pay and the whole organizations for putting that together. And to bring up some names that I've crossed paths with over the years through recreation, Leslie's mother, Ms. Pay, and think of other names that come along the line that we've worked with together in recreation. And the introducing of her sisters, who had a reminder to us that in some way, in a lot of ways, we're all connected. And when we kind of like look back into our family trees in a way. We're all connected some way. So it's just that togetherness that I've found that the message I got from their speeches and their presentation and the way they presented their culture when the youth is dancing, the message that they shared through that. And it was beautiful and very well attended. I couldn't find an empty seat in the whole place. Except the chow line, I found a space there.
So. Yeah, I caught the tail end of it, and I just got there just in time to see the mayor and vice mayor dancing along with the crowd, so it was a lot of fun. But it was my first time attending, so I definitely had a lot of fun, and I can see why it continues to be a really big part of the community and why it should still continue on. So looking forward to the ones in the future.
Absolutely. And then just moving straight along, may I, the Dolger supporters had a craft feed on the weekend. And I see smiles because I know some of us were there. I stopped by, and I will say that it was packed, wasn't it packed? There was people coming out of the rafters there, and I think if they had more room, they would have had more people. And I think it was sold out for a month, couple months, I guess. And yeah, I just wanted to say that. Besides, can I mention the wrestling one? The wrestling event, that was really good too. No, it wasn't. There was an event at the Pacelli Center, and APW, yes. All Pro Wrestling. I have to admit that. I know, like, I was a busy camper this month, oh. And I'd never been, my grown son, I'm going to embarrass the poor guy, and his good friend, we attended, and I have to say, I was amazed. I mean, you know, I've seen it on TV, but in person, it's just amazing. I'm sorry, she's laughing. I was telling Joseph was there with his son, and I was watching them swing people out of the ring. Thank you, I was gonna say something else. And I realized, you know, because I used to tell my kids, come on, that's not real, but holy smoke, when you come flying out of there, out of the ring, hitting the floor, there's people right there, you're watching going, oh my gosh, right? It was amazing. Wow. Joseph, you could take it.
I was just going to say, if it sounds too good to be true, you can come witness it yourself, because they are coming back to Pacelli. Yeah. Jim, on March 25th, and this group, which is not affiliated with the city of Daly City, they are just renter, but their program has grown so much, they are bringing professional wrestling to the Cow Palace, I believe on May 6th.
Yeah, that is correct.
For the first time in 35 years, and they're going to have a steel cage match, and anyway.
The play acting
if
is real.
If it sounds appealing, it's not our program.
No. But, you won't be wrestling. The mayor won't be wrestling. Nobody will be wrestling.
The play acting is real.
Well, let me tell you. You know, I saw some of that play acting, but some of it, I was sure. I was sure they were hurting themselves. I was sure of it.
Well,
same.
Maybe we ought to start each one of our meetings with a safety report first before we get to wrestling.
Anyway, just thought I'd share that with you. It was an amazing month here in the city of Daly City. That's all I was going to say.
Just in addition to the commissioner's report, just kind of like a side note relating to the presentation that we had from the Daly City baseball program. I have a collection of baseball gloves that if you have a youngster that find their way to the program needing a glove, I'd like to get them to you, because over the years, back in the day, I was coaching in the Daly City. Gloves tend to be left behind, and when the season ends, and no one ever came to claim them, except my garage. So I have a ton of gloves for you guys.
Nice.
To help out, get you started. So, okay, besides that, we're on to announcements and communications.
Yeah. Before we get to announcements, just to dovetail onto that remark, we also, as a city, have a lot of baseball gear in storage, and we're sorting through now, and any surplus equipment we have that's usable, we're going to donate to the Daly City Baseball Association.
Wow. Off to a right start.
And on to announcements. So this Saturday, March 4th, at the Ceremony Center from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m., We will be out there, as we often are, at the Fun Health and Safety Fair. It's a great community event, always well attended, and it gives folks a chance to get a preview of what it is that we do in both our libraries and our recreation programs. And a lot of other community partners will be out there too. So usually out by the food court, there's a main stage, and then all throughout the ceremony center, there'll be lots of wonderful information tables, but ours is always the best. So please stop by.
30 tables.
Please stop by and visit us this Saturday, March 4th, 10 to 3 at the Ceremony Center. I also want to mention, we talked about the Black History Month event, another one of our events that we do every year. It's going to be our 12th annual Women's History Month. That will be back at the Cafe Dolger on Thursday, March 16th. It was a very nice evening last night at the City Council meeting, where the Mayor and City Council did proclaim the month of March 2017 Women's History Month in Daly City, so it was very nice. We are looking forward to that program. The Mercy Burlingame singing group will be headlining the entertainment, but there'll be some ice cream and some speakers, and we're looking forward to that event. And one other thing I wanted to mention, last night the City Council recognized the Rotary Club for its 100th anniversary. Those of you who have been on the commission for a couple of years may remember we had a visit from the Daly City Como Rotary Club here back in 2015 with a very ambitious project that they wanted to partner up with us. And their dream that they are still clinging to is an outdoor fitness area that we talked about. In fact, we had conceptual drawings and renderings that we shared at a meeting in 2015 to build this. If you're familiar with the Larkham Clubhouse, there is a very old school playground there that is not really used because we have a wonderful playground closer to the tennis courts at Westlake Park. So we've tentatively picked that site. They have begun fundraising in earnest. It's taking maybe a little bit longer than they thought it might take, but it's good to have it back out in the public again. So if people want to contribute to that, it's been driven by the Daly City Rotary Club. Very good. And maybe we can have them come back and give a progress report, because it's been a couple of years since they came forward with the idea.
Yeah, I'd like to hear that.
And we certainly embraced it, and we're waiting.
That's it.
Great. Well, thank you for sharing those couple announcements with us, Joseph.
Well, I'm gonna sneak in one more.
Okay, go ahead.
And that is on Tuesday, March 14th, I hope I'm getting this right, the Daly City Public Library Associates has their annual fundraiser at the Como Community Center. It's a fundraiser for the Daly City Public Library Associates. They do a St. Patrick's Day celebration with a corned beef lunch, and visit the Daly City Public Library website to make your reservation. The event itself is free. Of course, your wallet might be a little bit lighter when you leave the event. It's a great fundraising opportunity, and they allow the library to bring forward three different ideas that we want to help support. So they'll be raising funds for the Daly City Public Libraries Tuesday, March 14th at the Colma Community Center. And please, if it's something that's interesting, make a reservation, because again, like kind of like the crab feed, it will be a full house. So yeah, Make sure you have a table.
Great. Okay. Well, again, anything else from the commission board that you'd like to bring forth before we close for this evening?
Just one event I forgot to mention earlier, but Luis and I got to attend the Books and Brews event.
Oh, right.
So I have the personally, I loved it just because I'm a beer fan, and so it's definitely a different type of event. But it was really rainy that day. It was a Thursday night. So I think it could have been a lot more well attended, but I think if it was on a Friday, maybe it would be kind of a good idea, because people have work the next day on Friday, right? So I don't know what Luis thought of, but I thought it was great for the price. 10 tastings, you get a beer glass, get to hang out, and get a whole bunch of food. So
wow,
good deal.
Yeah, it was nice to chill out. Nice to see your people. And it was actually on my day of my birthday as well.
Oh,
so
that's right. Happy
birthday. Thank you. Yeah, it was nice. We also saw you there, Joseph, and Yeah, I came there till pretty much towards the end, about 45 minutes. Yeah, but it was nice. And met some people there, and they were sharing some of the books, that ideas how to actually make the brews, which was nice as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for those of you not familiar with our books and brews series, that was the second. We are planning a third where it will be a smaller group again, but actually making a batch of beer.
Oh, wow. Oh.
Through the whole process and bottling it and nice. The whole bit. And just by chance, I ran into somebody this weekend from the Lagunitas Brewery up in Petaluma, and I shared, you know, what we had done, and they were really excited, and I'm expecting a call any day because he said their marketing people would really like to support an event like that too.
Wow.
So hopefully this series will get some momentum and keep going.
Great.
So when is the third one?
We don't have a date set yet. It will likely be at the Gellert Clubhouse. We need a kitchen space, so we haven't narrowed down the space, but it looks like we're teaming up with Speakeasy Brewery out of San Francisco.
Mm-hmm. Well, great. Great.
Wow, this is, and it's something you're thinking of doing, I'm just asking, is like a few, and then next year do it again, or something every so many months, so what does it sound
beer
like?
Beer never gets old, I think. Yeah. Just keep going.
Yeah, well,
okay. Yeah, somebody does.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. For our viewing public who just joined us, we talked about our new baseball program by the youth, and we talked about the health fair coming up. And we talked about the 12th annual Women's History Month coming up, and an upcoming brew and books and brew event that's scheduled to come in. So check our websites, check the Daily City website or the Recreation website to get an update on when those dates are going to be happening. And so without any further ado, if there's nothing else to bring forth, I call for a motion to conclude this evening's meeting. Do I get a motion?
I heard a motion here and a second here. I'm in the middle.
Okay, those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. This meeting is now ended.